This is the biggest innovation in microphones in my lifetime, and you have to watch the entire video before you tell me I'm wrong. I'm talking about mics
with frickin' laser beams attached to their heads.
Austin Powers? No? This is the Lewitt RAY, the world's first autofocus microphone. The RAY features what Lewitt calls their aura sensor, so it can always tell how far away you are from the mic. That allows this microphone to continuously adjust its volume based on the distance you are from the mic in real time. It's such a simple idea, but it's executed perfectly, and it helps give you more consistent and better sounding audio. If you're skeptical that it only works good in theory, stick around because I'll have some audio samples, and in my opinion, it works even better than I expected. The Aura sensor also enables another feature called mute by distance, which is exactly what it sounds like. So you can set this mic to mute completely as soon as you move far enough away from it. You simply hold the mute button while sitting at the distance you want it set to, and then the indicator will turn red, showing you that it's enabled. Anytime you're within that set distance, the word mute is green and the mic will pick up audio, but as soon as you move outside of that range, it turns red and the mic drops by 70 decibels. You just need to long press it again to disable it, or you can quick press the mute button to use it as a regular manual mute as well. At any time, you can turn the Aura sensors off and use this just like any other traditional mic. Now I'm going to show you how this mic sounds with and without Aura, as well as demonstrate the mute by distance feature. But don't leave right after that, because I want to talk about some concerns that I've heard from people who think the Aura technology might not be all positive. This is the Lewitt RAY with Aura turned off, and you can hear that as I move farther away from the mic and then back towards the mic, that the volume changes drastically. This is the Lewitt RAY with Aura turned on, and you can hear that as I move farther away from the microphone and then back towards the mic, that the volume remains much more consistent. Now I've got the mute by distance feature turned on, and you can hear that as soon as I move far enough away, or if you've got this mic on a boom arm like I do, all you have to do is swing the mic a little bit out of the way. Obviously, when you move far enough away from this mic, you will start to hear some more reverb and room echo, so you can't throw mic technique completely out the window, especially in an untreated space. But even when pushing the RAY to its limits, I was shocked at how well it works. It gives you a ton of freedom to move around and speak more naturally and not be so concerned with a constant proximity to your mic. If you're using it on a podcast, you can not only move around and communicate more naturally and comfortably with body language, but with the mute by distance feature, you can back off the mic and have it mute at any time. Like if you need to say something to your producer or cough or take a drink, really anything that you don't want picked up in the mic. If you're a content creator like me and you need some space to back off and show off a piece of gear or demonstrate something, it allows you to do that without the audio quality or volume dipping temporarily. As a vocalist, it allows you to focus more on your performance and less on perfect mic technique, which just makes the recording process more creative and less technical. If you do voiceover or narration work, this mic makes it easy to read manuscripts without the mic actually blocking your view. And it makes it so you don't have to worry as much about being the exact same distance from your mic every time you sit down to record. And that brings me to the concerns that I mentioned earlier. When I first told some narrator friends about the Lewitt RAY, their worry was that it might lose out on some of the nuance of their performance because it automatically adjusts the volume in real time. Sometimes you want to move up close to the mic for a more intimate, in-your-face sound, and sometimes you want to move farther away if you want to make it sound like somebody's talking from another room or something. As someone who actually engineers and masters audiobooks, I've seen the best and worst of audio over the years. So I know exactly what it takes to process audio, both good and bad, and I can tell you from experience that the Aura technology is only going to be a benefit. Volume is actually the least important thing when it comes to listeners understanding that you're talking in a different way. Things like change in vocal tone, dynamics, and room reverb are all far, far more important. In fact, one of the main things I do during audiobook editing is making sure the entire thing is as close to the same volume as possible throughout the entire book. This mic essentially does that for me, which saves a ton of time in post-processing, and if you're not somebody that knows how to do that during editing, it'll just give you better sounding raw audio. To show you what I mean, here's me talking very quietly And here's me talking very loudly. You obviously have no trouble telling the difference between those two things, even though they're technically the exact same volume. Another cool thing is that it kind of acts like a limiter, because I've noticed with the aura sensor turned on, it's a lot harder to get your audio to clip. So if you accidentally move too close to your mic during recording, it'll actually reduce the volume and give you some safety there. Unlike a real limiter or compressor, it doesn't actually change your audio, it just reduces the volume, so you're still gonna get a more natural sounding recording. You're probably also wondering, like I did, if the Lewitt RAY has a lot of self noise or requires a ton of gain to use. When I've got the Lewitt RAY set to 4 to 6 inches away and the audio peaking at around -9 decibels, I get a noise floor of -65. This mic is essentially tuned so that at 30 centimeters or around 1 foot, the output of the mic is going to be the same whether you have Aura turned on or off. So that's kind of the starting point, and with Aura turned on, as you move closer to the mic, the noise floor drops as the gain is decreased, and as you move away from the mic, the noise floor slightly increases as the gain of the mic increases. Long story short, or if you don't know what all those numbers mean, the self-noise of the Lewitt RAY is just as good as any other really good condenser microphone. And when it comes to gain requirements, the Lewitt RAY required 12 decibels less gain than my Rode Procaster. Obviously, that's a dynamic mic, but the point here is that the Lewitt RAY doesn't require anything special as far as gain or preamps go. I think the ideal use for Aura is in the 3 to 12 inch range. The difference in sound within that range is nearly imperceptible, which is great because that's where the vast majority of recording takes place. And again, it makes a huge difference and still sounds really good if you work outside that range. I didn't know what the price was going to be before testing this mic out. I just kind of assumed it was going to be over $500, but the Lewitt RAY retails for $349 and comes with a shock mount, a foam windscreen, a magnetic metal pop filter, and a carrying pouch. When I saw this mic was going to be less than $350, I was very pleasantly surprised. If you're at all interested in grabbing one of these mics, I suggest you do so immediately because I have a really good feeling they're going to sell out fast. But what do you think? Is the Aura technology as big of a deal as I make it sound? Leave a comment and let me know if you think the Lewitt RAY is a game changer or not. Links are in the description, and if you buy anything at all after clicking my links, that's the best way to support my channel at no extra cost to you. That's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.